Similar thing happened with Maharaj Bharat. When Maharaj Bharat became a deer, in the body of a deer he was able to remember his past life, that he was the emperor of the whole world. And because of that reason, in the body of the deer, he went back again to that same ashram where the rishis were practicing Krishna consciousness. There he went and he gave up his body there. Then he came as Jad Bharat. So the Lord's sanction and the Lord's hand has to be there. And here it was the will of the Supreme Lord. That's why Gajendra was able to remember his past life. So this is the unique position of a devotee of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. He welcomed the curse. And because the devotee is always aware that anything and everything happens in his life happens by the will of the Supreme Lord. Here the word upadharayan means, in this verse, the word upadharayan means considering, this is a very significant word here, upadharayan. This indicates that the devotee knows what is the situation of this material world. He understands very clearly. If he is a devotee in good knowledge, good understanding, then he knows that this has happened by the will of the Supreme Lord. Now, although the king was not at fault, here, the king was not at fault. Prabhupada is writing this, I am not saying this. And when this happened, the king considered it to be his past misdeeds. He did not think that Agastya Rishi has cursed me. He thought that this has happened because of my past deeds, my past misdeeds. Tattayenu kampam samikshamanam. This is the practical example how devotee takes a certain incident in one's life. Now, if a devotee has to suffer reactions of his past misdeeds, what does the Supreme Lord do? The Supreme Lord arranges for him to be given in a small token of these reactions. If there is something big has to happen, then it will happen in a small tokens, and very soon he will be freed from the reactions of these material contaminations. Now actually, Agastya Muni cursing Indradumna was on behalf of Lord Hari. He was cursing Indradumna Vanachari on behalf of Lord Hari. It was Lord's desire that he was cursing Indradumna. And one should therefore, Prabhupada is writing, one should therefore adhere to devotional service in any situation of life. One should continue in any unfortunate circumstances of life also, one should continue his practicing Krishna consciousness enthusiastically. By regularly following the regulative principles, and especially the principles of Shravanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu Smaranam. Hearing about the pastimes of the Lord, reading Srimad Bhagavatam and speaking about its glories. So one should always remain absorbed in the service of Bhagavatam, service of the Supreme Lord. In any unfortunate situation in the life as well, one should not give up. Now similar was the situation with Chitraketu Maharaj. Chitraketu Maharaj, who was the spiritual master? The great Narad Muni. Narad Muni gave him the mantra, and by the power of that mantra, Narad Muni was, by the power of the mantra, Chitraketu Maharaj was able to achieve great advancement at a very short time. He not only achieved the position of a Vidyadhar, but also he got darshan of Lord Anantadev in person. And because of that, what happened? As soon as Maharaj Chitraketu saw Lord Supreme Lord, he was cleansed of all material contamination and was situated in original Krishna consciousness. He was completely cleansed of his contamination. But this Chitraketu Maharaj, who was given a plane by Lord Vishnu himself, he was traveling in that plane, and it happened that he went through Kailash. And while he was traveling through the mountain Kailash, he saw a very unusual scene. He saw that his very dear friend Lord Shiva. Now he was a very dear friend of Lord Shiva. In his talks to Parvati also, he says that Chitraketu is my friend because he is a very dear devotee of Lord Anantadev. Sankarsana is, that's why he is like my god brother. He is very, very dear to me. So this was not known to Parvati ji. And Chitraketu Maharaj he actually glorified Lord Shiva. That you are such a self-controlled person. You are an acharya of a sampradaya. But how great is you that that Parvati is sitting on your lap and you are speaking Krishna katha. He is giving a lesson to the grahasthas that grahasthas, oh my dear grahasthas, although you are married, but please continue speaking Krishna katha. This is a lesson which Lord Shiva is giving to the grahastha as an acharya. So Chitraketu Maharaj was actually, what was he doing? He was jokingly glorifying his friend Shiva. Like there are two friends, might be that one is married, one is brahmachari. And the wife don't know that this brahmachari is a very good friend of my husband, very intimate friend of my husband. And this brahmachari, he jokes with that grahastha in front of the wife. And the wife gets offended. So this was a situation here, the Parvati Mataji got offended. And Parvati Mataji said, Mr. Chitraketu, you don't know who is Lord Shiva. You don't know his glories. Chitraketu Maharaj said to himself, I know his glories very well. He is my friend, I know his glories. You are not fit to be in that position of a Vaishnava. Chitraketu Maharaj was amazed and he said, you should go and take birth as a demon. And Chitraketu Maharaj here accepted this curse. It is said that Sukadeva Goswami says, Iti Bhagavato Devya Prati Shaptum Alantam Murdhasa Jagrohe Shapam Evata Sadhu Lakshanam. This is the lakshan of a sadhu, that if there is a curse uttered to him, he will accept it as the will of the Lord. And Chitraketu Maharaj accepted this as the will of the Lord and said, my dear mother, thank you very much. And he accepted the body of Ratrasur. And Lord Shiva told her that, Parvati, you don't know the glories of the devotees of Lord Hari. They will never curse anybody. And if the curse comes on them, they will accept it very happily. Now see, even after he is becoming a demon, his devotion will be unaffected. His prema of the Lord will be unaffected. So, Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, he says in his Madhurya Kadambini that Chitraketu actually did not curse Lord Shiva. From external vision, Chitraketu never offended Lord Shiva. Actually, from external vision, it might have seemed that there is an offense, but it was not an offense. And Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur says that the curses actually do not take proper effect on the on this great souls like Chitraketu Maharaj who are devotees. What happens? That Chitraketu did not lose his spiritual wealth, which is he was his prema for the Supreme Lord. He did not lose. Similar what the situation with Indradyumna. Indradyumna did not lose his spiritual wealth, prema. That same thing continued in the body of elephant, and when he was in a difficult situation, the Lord, he was lovingly offering prayers and the Supreme Lord came. So this is the life of Indradyumna and Chitraketu. Now let us shift to the life of Huhu. This is the today's verse. Now who was Huhu?